Crawlee for Python is a powerful browser automation and web scraping library that simplifies the process of building reliable scrapers. It manages complex overhead tasks for you, allowing you to focus on your scraping logic. In this video, we'll show you how to use it and demonstrate some of its key features. To get started quickly, copy the command from the homepage in the docs and paste it into your terminal. Then choose either the Beautiful Soup or Playwright template from the drop-down list and hit enter on the one you prefer. It will create some boilerplate code for you. After that, run the installation with Poetry install. As you can see, there's no need to install any additional middleware in Crawlee for Python. You can set up your crawler in just 10 lines of code. After the installation is done, CD it into the new project folder that you just created, and you'll see that there are already a bunch of files there for you, such as mainpy and rootspy. In this example, we're going to use request bin to create an endpoint and to inspect the requests that Crawlee will be sending over to that endpoint. Remember how we said that Crawlee for Python handles all the overhead of web crawling for you? Well, we weren't kidding. You can use the Proxy Configuration class to automatically rotate through proxies. Simply create a new instance, pass it into a crawler, and pass in a list of proxy URLs that you'd like to rotate through. And that's it. Crawlee will handle the rest. We can send a request to this request bin to see that it's actually using our proxies. Once the request is made, we can check it out in the request bin and see that Crawlee is in fact using one of the IP addresses in our proxy list. Crawlee will also rotate the proxies from the list to avoid getting blocked. Up to this point, we've been using a Beautiful Soup crawler, which makes plain HTTP requests. But we can easily change over to a Playwright crawler that runs a headless browser just by switching around some imports and a few lines of code, and then installing the Playwright package. So now let's build a simple recursive crawler using Playwright crawler, so you can use the full power of Playwright's page API. We want to scrape the title of each page of Crawlee Python with the URL, and save it somewhere. Luckily, Crawlee's got that covered for us as well. Instead of importing a new class and manually creating an instance of the dataset, you can use the context helper push data class. First, we'll scrape the title with Playwright, and then save it to the default dataset by calling the context push data function and passing a dictionary with the title. And that's it. All of our titles will now be saved to the disk. The stored data can then be interacted with in the future using methods like the getData function. In order to make this a recursive crawler, we'll use the enqueue links function to automatically enqueue all Crawlee Python links on each page to the request queue. To do this, we can simply call this function. When you start this crawler, you'll notice that an automated Chrome browser opens up and first goes to the Crawlee homepage, then starts recursively crawling through every page on the website. Once the crawl is finished, you'll notice in the storage folder that there are now a bunch of new items in the default dataset, automatically enumerated for you. These are all the result of us calling the context push data function. So now you have an insight into Crawlee and how it lets you easily manage complex tasks like proxy rotation and recursive crawling, so you can build scalable and reliable crawlers quickly. Want to learn more? The Crawlee documentation provides detailed information and a full range of features. So go and check it out.